Hello everyone, I'm Bhanu Prakash from the Department of Civil Engineering at IIT Roorkee. So I'm going to offer a 30-hour course titled Environmental Remediation of Contaminated Sites. So it's relevant to both the UG and the PG students, and it is typically offered as an elective course. Again, what's the relevance of this particular course? The title is self-explanatory, it's Remediation of Contaminated Sites. So as you are aware of, let's say, especially in a country like India, which is a developing country, we have a lot of sites that are relatively contaminated with various industrial contaminants, let's say, right? We have, let's say, due to lax enforcement or lack of technical knowledge, let's say, we have different sites that are contaminated with different contaminants. These contaminants can be hydrophobic, right? They do not want to stay in water, they want to be adsorbed onto, let's say, soil or such, or they are relatively hydrophilic, and thus, let's say, you know, they can be transported by the groundwater across larger distances or great distances, let's say, right? So we are going to look at different cases, let's say, and look at the relevant technical options available to remediate those particular sites. So before we dig deeper, we typically are going to look at what are the potential risks associated with this particular site, let's say, right? So you are going to have a relevant population nearby that particular contaminated site. We are going to look at how they are going to be affected, what are the relevant pathways, let's say, and calculate the relevant risks associated by that particular contaminated site to that population, let's say, right? So let's say this is the risk. And depending upon the standards and the relevant health concerns, we are going to look at what is the risk that we need to bring it down to, let's say, right? And then I'm going to look at how do I bridge this gap, right? So obviously we are going to look at the relevant technical options to be able to bridge this gap between the current risk posed to the relevant population and the relevant risk that I want to bring it down to, so that no adverse health effects are experienced by the relevant population. So typically we are going to look at two cases, as in remediation of groundwater and also remediation of contaminated soil and sediment. So while we are going to look at the relevant aspects independently, out there in the nature though, or in the site, let's say, or the practical conditions that you are going to experience, you are not going to have only contamination of groundwater or only contamination of soil or sediment. But for better understanding and clarity, we are going to look at them separately. In the context of remediating groundwater, let's say, we are going to look at options like just containing the plume, which is plume containment, pumping the relevant water or contaminated groundwater out and treating it, which is called pump and treat, let's say, and then putting in place subsurface barriers, which are called permeable reactive barriers. We are also going to look at natural attenuation, right? And then in the context of soil and sediment contamination and the relevant remediation, we are going to look at the more obvious aspects such as excavation and putting it in a landfill, and then look at relevant aspects or remediation techniques such as solidification and stabilization, soil vapor extraction, thermal washing, phytoremediation, and so on and so forth, let's say, right? So there are many options out there. And then after each particular aspect or discussing each aspect, we are going to look at or discuss briefly about a particular case study, let's say, right? So the idea is to look at the relevant practical aspects involved, right? So then we are going to look at a complex site where we need to look at multiple options or solutions to be able to remediate that site, right? So again, as I mentioned earlier, the course is remarkably relevant in the Indian context. So I look forward to interacting with you over the course of the semester. Thank you.